just currently waiting for them to arrive, and then the build will be done. So expect that video out in about, let's say, 3 to 4 days. So right now it's the 9th. Let's say expect it on either the 12th or the 13th, depending when all the parts arrive. So
all right, so all of the parts are here, and before we start putting it in the case, I'm just going to be doing a quick little test to see if all the parts work. So yeah, first thing we're going to do is we're going to be installing the CPU. Just got to unhinge the hook, pull it upwards. As I match the golden triangle with the marking on the motherboard, I don't know if you can see it, it's right there. And just drop it into place, and then you put it back down, and boom, CPU installed. Okay, so now that the CPU is installed, I'm going to install the cooler, and then I'm going to do the RAM. Alright, there we are, the CPU has been installed, so the cooler has been installed. So now we just got to do the RAM. It's quite easy, it can just be a one-handed job, you just got to line up the notches. Motherboard and CPU and RAM are all set to go. Alright, so now I've actually hooked up the power supply, I've got the motherboard and the CPU power connected. I've connected like my keyboard, mouse, and the HDMI cable because it's going to be running for onboard graphics. So yeah, this bench is quite messy right now, but I'm going to plug in the power supply and see if we can get a post. Alright, so far so good. I turned on the PSU after plugging it in. So now the last thing I have to do is just jump these cables. There we go. It's on. Both fans are spinning. We should see a post in a minute. Probably going to turn off and turn back on to just train memory. We've got a light. Keyboard's on. That's a sign. There we go! It's on this monitor, so I'm just going to quickly switch around the cables, but we do have a post. Let's go. Alright, nice. This is actually a lot smoother than I anticipated it to be. I thought we were going to be doing some sort of troubleshooting, but it looks like we can just go straight into the BIOS. Yep, there we are. Temperatures seem good. I mean, I'm getting quite a lot of air just coming out of this fan, to be honest. It looks like it's barely turning, but it is actually turning. I'm going to quickly turn on DSEP to get out to 3200, and yeah, I guess the test works. Okay, so here's where we left off. Today is the day. It's been a couple days since we tested if the build posted, but now we're completely ready. I have all of the stuff necessary to build, so yeah, first things first, we're just going to install the SSD, get that out of the way. We did have to change from our original plan. We were going on the SanDisk X400, I think it was, but we actually had some issues with the shipping, so we ordered like a same day delivery WD green one for the same capacity, so there's not going to be any difference there, but yeah, just sort of allows us to do the build even sooner. So installing an M.2 SSD, really easy, just literally put it in like a 45 degree angle, and boom, there it is. Now you gotta screw it down. And that is finally the motherboard fully complete. SSD is installed, got the CPU cooler, the RAM. So yeah, now I think it's about time to just switch over to the case. Bro, when I ordered this case, I was like, oh yeah, it's gonna be quite small, I need a screwdriver for this. When I ordered this case, I thought, oh yeah, it's gonna be like a bit small, but it's not gonna be anything super tiny. But this thing is actually like really small. I mean, this is the case compared to my PC. You can just see the size difference. It's like just like a little microwave. But yeah, I am quite interested to see how this goes. I mean, from the reviews online, I've seen that it's quite a reliable case. I just nearly stabbed it there. There we go. Wait. There we go. We got it open, boys. As you can see, we've got all the front panel connectors. I'm just going to kind of move these to the side here. A couple things that we can't really move is this. This is the power cable extender that will actually go into the power supply. And then this is the cable for the fan.
Thing that I saw online, which would actually be better for airflow, is if I flipped this fan, so it was actually an intake instead of an exhaust, and then we used the power supply fan, the power supply is going right there, as an exhaust. So it'd be intaking air, pushing it through the front of the case, and then it'll be exhausting it out of the power supply. And I think that's actually going to be a pretty good idea, instead of just having two exhausts, so air going out there and air going out there, you've sort of got like a good flow going on. Alright, there we go, we flipped the fan, so now it's an intake instead of an exhaust. As you can see here, the arrow is pushing this way. So yeah, I think that's going to give us just a bit more airflow, and I think it's time to install the power supply and then the motherboard.
Well, that's just great.
So it turns out the motherboard that I have is too big for this case, because the power supply is mounted there, because this motherboard is Micro ATX, but it's a bit more sort of wide than normal Micro ATX ones. So, back to shopping. Okay, so it's been 2 days, but we're back. This case just is too small to fit in the motherboard and the power supply. So we've gone for a little bit of an upgrade. I think it's like £15 cheaper. This is the Cooler Master Masterbox Q300, I think it is. I'll have the product on the screen now. And yeah, I've already taken off the side panel just so you can see inside a lot better. But, you know, it's more of a standard form factor PC. As you can see, you've got like your I/O tray, your PCI covers, your power supply and stuff. So, yeah, it does have only one fan, but I'm just going to be taking a fan from a previous system and putting it in here. So it's going to have two fans. And yeah, it's not as big as a standard full-sized ATX tower, but, you know, I feel like it will do the trick pretty well. And my mum actually ordered this with it. It's like a Maleficent pop vinyl, and she's gonna have that, like, you know, somewhere in her PC to look cool. So yeah, now let's get on to actually installing the motherboard. One handy thing that I've actually noticed, this motherboard tray isn't actually flush with like the back of the case, which is really nice, because like you have lots of room here. I'd say that's probably like 4 or 5 centimeters just of room for cables. So that's actually going to help cable management very well. I mean, there isn't like a power supply shroud or anything, and there isn't cable grommets, it's just kind of cutouts, but having that extra room is really going to help. So yeah, thanks Cooler Master. This case came pre-installed with some standoffs, so what I'm doing right now is just sort of adding the ones that will fit appropriately with the screws in the motherboard. One thing that I really like sort of more premium case brands are, even if they're more budget cases, they come with this tool. This is basically for installing motherboard standoffs. As you can see, there's like a little hexagon shape there, which you can just kind of plonk it over the screw, and then you can take your screwdriver and then screw in the thumb screw just like an ordinary screw. The standoffs are installed now, so we're ready to screw in the motherboard. And before people yell at me, wait, Harry, you forgot the IO shield. Let me explain something. So I bought this motherboard used on eBay for £35, which I'm pretty sure is like $45, if my conversion is correct. And yeah, this was a really good price for this board. It's probably one of the cheapest Ryzen desktop like boards I could find. But yeah, one caveat to buying used on stuff like eBay and just used in general is sometimes the board won't come with all of the accessories, or any accessories at all in my case. I have ordered a replacement IO shield, but basically the board literally came like this, obviously without the CPU and SSD, but it was genuinely just sat in this box, like probably banging around in shipping and stuff, which is not good. So yeah, that's why. I mean, I've already tested it to make sure that it works, and fortunately it does. I made sure that this seller had a return policy, like, before I ordered it, in case it did die, because, you know, it's used. But, yeah, it all works, and I guess I just sort of got out lucky this time, but if it doesn't come with any packaging, it might be a little less reliable, so I would check it and then send it back if it doesn't work. Alright, so the motherboard is fully screwed in on all points. This thing is not going anywhere. You see, if I move the motherboard, then the entire desk moves, so you can see that this thing's secure. Like I said before, I will replace this with an actual IO shield when it arrives. It's just, you know, it's just not here yet. I might just keep on talking about this, but like, I love the amount of space. Like, just for like a screwdriver for measurement, you can see like, you can see how much space there is just between the actual back plate and the back of the case. Like, you have so much room here. I'm gonna put in like a fan hub, by the way. This isn't just gonna lead to nowhere. But like, this is insane. All right, so I've made some progress. I've mounted the front panel connectors. People with a keen eye might have also noticed that I've plugged in the SATA cable. That's because I've already mounted the hard drive. As you can see, it's just chilling here. This cable is quite long, so I've sort of run it underneath the hard drive. But you know, I feel like it's not that noticeable from the other side. I feel like now would be a good time to install the power supply. And then I think that's about it. The way that you install this power supply is actually pretty interesting. As you can see, there's sort of like a little bracket that you screw it into, which comes from the back of the case. And I guess you just kind of, I think you just kind of slide the bracket up to the back of the case like that. And then you just screw it in from there. It's kind of recessed, which I kind of like, to be honest. Okay, so now that the power supply is screwed in, I've kind of got a dilemma. It's either I put all of the cables through this hole, or I put all of the cables through that hole. I feel like I'm probably going to go with the hole on the right, just because if I put all of the cables through this hole, then it's going to be really cramped, and then sort of the right side will be quite empty, because I think my mum would probably want to get the pop vinyl maybe on top of the power supply. I mean, I think that looks decent. So, if she's not going to be using this right side for anything, I feel like it's going to seem quite empty, so I'm going to be running these cables just sort of through this hole, I guess. Alright, so there we are. I've tried to, like, do some cable management. I really tried to utilize this bottom sort of tray to just stash away most of the cables. I've also installed the fan header. I've also installed the fan hub. This just sort of goes to the extra... This just sort of goes to the extra header on the motherboard, so I can plug all of the stuff at the back. So, yeah, let's just plug those in. There we go, that's one. And that's two. Yes, I did also install the spare fan. Yeah, this is how it looks. I could have maybe done a tiny bit better with the cable management. Maybe like this bottom half if I zip tied it a bit tighter or something. But I did a pretty good job of hiding the cables. You can't really see most of the ketchup on my side. I mean, you can see a little bit through that hole there, but yeah, the last thing I have to do is install the Wi-Fi card on this bottom PCI slot here, and then we're ready to boot. These PCI slot covers are literally just the ones that you have to bend back and forth, which kind of sucks because, you know, it's a cooler master case, and even the Colink one had like a screwing mechanism. But you know, I mean, I doubt she's gonna be doing much expansion or anything, so yeah, it's alright, I guess. Boop. There we go. There we go. Boom. That's the last thing that we need to screw in. It's all secure and stuff. And yeah, that's about it for the PC. Plus, no, I didn't forget the antennas. And here we are. The moment of truth. It's all plugged in and stuff. My mum's blue-tacked the pop vinyl to the power supply. So right now, I guess we gotta just turn it on. PC gods say that turning on a new PC with the front panel on is bad luck, so I am not gonna do that. There we go. All of the fans are spinning. Just gonna get into BIOS. There we go, we got a post, let's go. Let me check if everything's there. We've got the RAM. I've already set the DOCP. We've got the fans. And yeah, that's basically it. We've got it. It is done. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the video.
And yeah, that's basically it for the video. Sorry for the short ending. It's just I decided to stop recording then and call it a day. So yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. It was pretty fun to make the build. I'm going to have like the PC part picker link to the full build in the description. So if you guys want to go look at that link, read my actual thoughts on this, then yeah, that's going to be in the description. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Peace.